salam and good evening to you, worthy friends. Welcome to the fabled city of Agrabah, city of flying carpets, soaring heroes, famous love ballads, and more glitz and glamour than any other fictional city in the world. You've never been? Well, we can fix that!
Hello, and welcome to a brand new video on this channel. Amazing, isn't it? I know. Yeah, welcome back to a new video. We are back at a very, 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 very old map. I would say this map is, let me think. I don't know when I entered this map the last time, like before I discovered it a few days ago. But honestly, this feels kind of nostalgic because I updated this map so many times in the past, and in the previous videos you could see how many things I changed, and to see this in the old shape, in the old classic way, is really, really interesting to see. So, why are we here today? Today I wanted to show you something that I actually never showed anyone, except a few people on the Discord. As you guys probably know, I posted the Lion King version 2 around a year ago. But before that, a few of you might have actually discovered other videos on this channel that may be a little bit older. For example, the old Lion King version, Lion King version 1, which is actually located in this theater. But there was another project I posted. I don't remember when I started posting videos about it. I think it was like March or April 2020, maybe later. I posted videos about a Minecraft Aladdin show. The version was not really super realistic, it was more like my interpretation of the show. And yeah, I don't know, I kinda liked the version, but it was special in its own way. If you haven't checked it out yet, feel free to check it out on the channel. I think I posted a few videos, for example, A Friend Like Me, I think the grand finale, the opening Arabian Nights, and a few more songs. And yeah, I want to show you how I managed to create this show, and I want to show you the problems I got, the mistakes I made or whatever, and show you a few things, maybe help you improve your own Minecraft versions of shows, and show you that, yeah, my shows are not always like the Lion King show. I think 8 episodes of making of the Lion King version 2 were pretty high quality for my standards, and I really showed like all the things I paid attention to working on the Lion King version 2. And this here is more like completely chaos. I really didn't do this for YouTube, this was mainly for me. And when I started uploading a few Lion King version 1 videos, I thought maybe the people would like to see some Aladdin stuff. So that's why we're here, let's check it out. So before we start, as I said, I focused a lot on the Lion King version 2 in the past. I was thinking about the situation that I never really showed the backstage. But the problem was I kind of lost the whole map. I lost both the Aladdin version and the old Lion King version. But luckily I actually discovered this save file, I don't know, somewhere on my old drive. And yeah, that's why we're here. And now I would say let's have a look at this theater. So, before we go inside, let me give you a little overall look of the theater. It's based on the German theater called Staatstheater an der Elbe. Nice. So, this is actually based on a real theater. Even though in this particular theater, they never really showed Aladdin. They showed Aladdin in the same city where this theater is located, but this theater in general, there was never the Aladdin show in it. But I think in this theater they showed a few shows. I'm talking about the real life theater right now. In the real life theater they had Pretty Woman, I think, Mary Poppins, Tarzan, or whatever it's pronounced in English. And they actually plan to do Frozen in this particular theater next year. So I'm excited to see that. But yeah, for my personal use, I just thought I wanted to have a nice theater, and I thought, yeah, maybe just build a theater next to this one, and there was just this theater that would make sense. So yeah, we are here with a stage theater. What you can see around here is actually the backstage building, the backstage area. This is obviously the Fly Tower. This is all around the backstage building. And this is basically, yeah, the audience, the auditorium with a few ventilation systems and all these kind of things. A little bit of detail I put in there and here and yeah. So let's have a look at the lobby. The lobby itself looks a little bit empty right now, but there's a reason for that. I used to have a furniture mod installed in this particular map, and I had a lot of chairs and possibilities for the people to wait here. But because I removed that mod, yeah, it's completely empty. So normally you would have like have little chairs and possibilities to sit down and relax, but these are all gone because of the mod. So yeah, we have a big empty hallway. So we have a bar over here. Beautiful bar and a room that I never really used. We have another. This is the with the wardrobe or the whatever where you put the jackets and all these kind of things. The box office, obviously, another wardrobe, another little bar, and I think there's nothing over here. Yep. So let's actually go to the auditorium. Let's go inside. Yeah, same goes for here. I had a lot of seats that I used from this mod. They are now all gone, so we only have an empty auditorium. But this is the theater. People who watch the videos might remember this. And as I said, it's based on a real theater, even though the real theater is a little bit more, I would say, compressed. But yeah, let's focus on the stage. So we have a little some sort of orchestra pit. I mean, it's more like an, I don't know. You come into the theater, you look at the stage, and you think, oh, there's an orchestra pit. That's the whole idea. There's nothing really here. And we have this stage, the huge, huge, huge stage. It's huge in comparison to the Lion King stage. So as you can see, it's way more like compact or whatever. So the stage itself looks kind of nice, I would say. We could actually have, before we go to the scenery itself, let's actually have a look below the stage. I don't want to show everything right now, but you could probably already see a lot. So this is below the stage. As you can see, I needed more lights over here, and a lot of pistons for some sort of I wouldn't call them lifts. It's more like just trapdoors where I could like place actors, but they're not really working like actual theater lifts. It's just holes in the floor. That's the area below. So let's actually have a look at the stage itself. The best way to do this is to remove all the scenery. A few of you guys might remember when I talked about alternatives for like structure moving mods. One of them was called Slider Mall, and that's actually this one over here, the Slider Mall mod. Let's do a super short preview. You shift, right click them, put some blocks in there, for example, that's wrong area. For example, 5 blocks, and then you power the block up, and then it will extend the blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's how all the curtains work. It was pretty easy. You couldn't do multiple colors in one block, so I was limited to the way I worked. But yeah, let's actually remove all the areas right now. So as you can see, we're done right now. I used a lot of them. I used a lot of these sliders. So after this project, I knew that I never wanted to use this mod again. It's nice, you know, it can be useful, but at some point it gets laggy and at some point it gets buggy. And I started to overuse them, as you can see. Like the whole stage, there's nothing really there, like no real scenery part. This was a good example of a bug and stuff like that. There's not a lot going on. You could, like, I don't know. It's hard to describe. You see that there's literally just nothing except these sliders that would move everything in there. So if I put, for example, let's go over here to the tech area. If I wanted to have like the orange wings, I would actually need to activate those, and this would look like this. So now I have the wings. They all come down from here. As you can see, they're powered up with redstone now. And for example, if I would like to have, I don't know, the white background, I would probably just click. Oh yeah, by the way, this is all in German because I never thought about creating something in English. Yeah, white background, and you can see the stage is insanely huge. It's just not realistic at all. And to add the city, there's nothing smoothly coming in. It's just clone commands. So for example, where's Agrabah? Agrabah, I think it's over here somewhere. Agrabah, pew. And that's it. It's just, it instantly gets cloned or copied on the stage. I will show you the clone command areas later on, but yeah, that's basically how I moved all the scenery parts in there. Let's put down the main curtain, for example. As you can see, they all work the same. I either had clone commands or I had sliders, and that was the only way I could easily change the whole stage, for example. Yep, that's basically it. It's interesting how it works, but it's a very bad way to pull it off, from my point of view. But yeah, that's how the stage system worked in the core. Also, I didn't really pay attention to like style or whatever. It's just completely open. Like, I started to do something good over here with glass, so I could always have a look at the stage. But at some point, I was just like, yeah, whatever. So it looked pretty chaotic at the end. I had a few particles. Let's see if they are still working. I don't think the particles are still working. Oh, wait. Are they turned off? Maybe they're turned off. Probably turned off. Oh, yeah. There we go. Like, they were weird. Sometimes they worked. Sometimes they didn't. I don't know. This was the death of Jafar. So, besides that, I had a pretty simple light system. I only got five colors, blue, green, orange, red, and white. 1, 2, 3, 4, one on the top, one at the back, and as I showed before, downstage. A lot of lights, a lot of light bugs happened because of that, and I could only turn them on or off. I couldn't, like, I didn't have any special scenes or whatever, just randomly clicking them, activating them, deactivating them. It was still a lot of work for me because I never really worked with redstone that intense until these shows. But yeah, at some point I just started to get more and more advanced. Good example for that is the Lion King show. So, I think that's already it for the tech area. Let's go to something else that might be interesting for a few people. The Blockbuster area. Oh yeah, as you can see, there's nothing here in the backstage, nothing interesting. But we have the Blockbuster room over here. As you can see, we have all the scenes, Arabian Nights, One Jump, and Proud of Your Boy. Is it Proud of Your Boy? I think so. Million Miles, Diamond, Friend Like Me. These are all people from Friend Like Me. Act 2 opening, Prince Ali. These are all Prince Ali characters, scenes. Dialogue, Prince Ali, A Whole New World, Jafar, Ali Confront, High Adventure, Somebody's Got Your Back, Proud of Your Boy Reprise. Grande Finale support, and the credits, which doesn't make any sense because it's curtain call or bow, but not credits. But okay, Givensko, okay. But yeah, that's the area. We can actually have access to one of the scenes, but it's going to be pretty laggy just because it's a very old Blockbuster version. Let's right click them. And we wait, and wait, and wait, and wait, and wait. Ah, there we are. Oh yeah, the stage and light matches were just Steve's. And I had all these stolen skins from Spotlight Studios or whatever, and all these characters. This was actually a character I made by myself. The rest is pretty much just randomly picked from the internet. And now I can definitely say that it is way more fun to create your own skins, because you can just see your own, like, your own art style or whatever in the show. And these were so randomly, all these skins were so random, they didn't really fit at all. Let's have a look at the Blockbuster GUI for a second. Let's check them out. Like, they were so, oh wow, the Lion King assets are in here. Okay, good to know. Yeah, all these characters, including the old Lion King characters. Ooh, beautiful, right? Amazing. But yeah, as I said, it's a very old project of mine. But yeah, that's the Blockbuster area. I covered up the blockbuster area, the tech area. Now let's go down to the tech redstone area. If you remember the area from the Lion King version 2, where I have like multiple levels of redstone. Well, that's not the case here. It's just, yeah, that's it. I really don't have anything else except these little buttons over here. And I think this is like, this whole area over here is the whole auditorium light. And the rest is just random things. Let me check. Wonder gold. Oh, black floor. Wonder cave. Interesting. That's the wonder cave. Yeah, the rest is all German, but it's all very simple. It's just clone commands or redstone placing commands. It was not a complex show at all. I covered up basically everything except for... Oh my god. Here, another good example why I don't use slider mall anymore. Like, what is this? Ugh. Let's go to an area that I called the clone command area, or I don't know, the what did I call them? Oh yeah, it's like construction stages. So this is below stage, this is like main stage, says main stage, attention. And here we have different construction stages where I place different different scenery parts that I could clone in. For example, the entrance, the flying carpet that is not flying at all, it's just static. Or the back entrance of the Wonder Cave. And I have a few of them, let me check on them. The city, number 2. Okay, this is, I think that's the home of Aladdin. As you can see, it was not inspired by the main show at all. It was just randomly placed sandstone and some colors and that's it. Here we have the cave, gold stuff, and oh yeah, the bag that I completely copied from someone else, but who cares? There was a lamp over here. It's not there anymore. So the lamp was actually the first time I paid for something. I actually paid for an OBG lamp model, which was pretty or like super laggy at the end. And I don't even use it anymore. Today I would just use it, create it by my own with voxel models or whatever. But in this case, it actually was an OBG model. Pretty laggy OBG model. But it was beautiful. Let's show you the city. Oh, interesting. And the little prison for Babcock, Omar, Aladdin, and Kasim. This is Agrabah. Yeah, that's how Aladdin comes in. Just trapdoors behind it. Pretty obvious, I guess. But yeah, as you can see, I had these little stages. They were all down the floor, except this one. I built this higher, and I don't even know why. But yeah, they're all down here. If I go into spectator mode, we can check them out and see how big this whole area goes. Yeah. Oh my god. Mine's everywhere. We had 2 stages over here and 1 over there. And this area behind me. So yeah. When we go down here, there's just no aesthetic at all. It's just cave, straight cave. We have some clone commands over here that do the opening for the scene, the sand that moves up. Here you can see how the banners are moving up really slow, but they do their job. This moves up and up even more, and as you can see, it actually disappears up here. It's not like it still exists, it just disappears. And at the end, I think it's actually just, there's nothing except the fences and the banners. But yeah, that's it. That's the Aladdin stage. It is pretty complex in a way, but it also pretty amateur way thingy. You know what I mean? A few of the mistakes I made, yeah, like I didn't care about the actors. If I start the scenes, let's see if I actually can start a scene right now. You can see that they all start behind the wings. And I don't know, this kind of breaks the illusion for me. In the Lion King show, you can actually perform on stage and you can walk behind the stage because the actors prepare behind the stage and do stuff that you can't even see as a viewer. But in this case, it's really just the stuff that happens up here. Oh yeah, a lot of characters. I think that's the Aladdin Prince Ali finale. Yep. Oh my god. A lot of characters, and here we go. So yeah, this was one of my mistakes. It was not realistic at all. I mean, all the things just came in cloning and popping up and popping out, and the lighting, oh, it was not good. There were a lot of light bugs and light, like empty holes where no light was going. You can see that we have light bugs over here, and there's no light over here, you know, it's just a light bug randomly. I think there's so many things going wrong. Yeah, the light would move around if you walk around because there were so many lights, and I didn't change the config. I had no clue what to do. But yeah, everyone starts at some point. I just wanted to make this video to show you that I'm not perfect. I did many mistakes before I could pull off a show like The Lion King. That's it for this theater, for this little theater backstage tour. You obviously can't download the map. I don't publish my blockbuster shows. If you want to do your own show, but you don't want to build your own theater, there are two theaters I built that are uploaded on this channel, and you can download them for free. And I think also the Lion King behind the scenes videos kind of give you an introduction to how to create your own show or find your own style or whatever. And if you have any more questions or want to do it on your own or whatever, just join our Discord. If you want to create your own shows and want to present them to others, you're more than welcome to our Discord. And if not, I will see you in the next video, I would say. If you're interested in seeing the backstage area of the first Lion King version, the differences between the modern version and the old version, if you're interested in that, just leave a like or whatever, write a comment or let me know. And I will show you the backstage area of this theater and how everything works. Because this is also a lot different to the actual Lion King version 2 that you saw on my channel. Even though it looks pretty similar to the one you could see on the show, it was like extremely different. For example, there are no clouds. Interesting, right? I know. Okay, that's it for this video. As I said, if you're interested in this version, in a little backstage tour, let me know. But I hope this whole video was at least a little bit interesting to see and to watch. I actually really enjoy to look back at this theater to see my old things and discover it in some sort of new way. So thanks for watching, and I would say see you in the next video. Bye bye. Dreaming a whole new world.
Happy ending! For you and